During the final stage of incubation, the python's skin turns dull and her eyes cloudy, indicating that she is in shedding. Snakes shed their skin soon after hatching to get rid of mites, skin bacteria, and to remove the smell of your own eggs. Only then will the python begin feeding again. With reduced eyesight and the hatching of her young, she becomes vulnerable to predators, reflecting in her increasingly nervous behavior. The embryos are almost fully developed after 60 days of incubation, surrounded by a web of blood vessels, various membranes, and sufficient fluids to prevent the hatchlings from drying out. After breaking through the gas-exchanging chorion membrane, the hatchling has only 30 minutes to cut its way out of the protective leathery shell, or else it will drown in its own fluids. The female continues guarding her eggs, but takes no part in the hatching at all. In fact, she removes herself from the eggs now, and only returns when sensing danger. But the young Burmese pythons refuse to leave their eggs immediately. Most of them gaze at their new surroundings, while others prefer to remain within the protective shell. The millipede might have been attracted by the oozing egg fluids and doesn't mean to harm the snakes, while a vicious attack from an army of fire ants could result in the death of many hatchlings. For the next 3 days, the young pythons will frequently poke their heads outside, only to retreat back into the safety of their eggs a few minutes later. The reason for this behavior is that all hatchlings are still connected to the yolk sac, which provides their needed nutrition. Unable to leave the eggs, the hatchlings will rest mostly during the final stage of their development and only move to the surface to breathe the needed air. But not all pythons will hatch. If unable to cut through the shell and breathe, the snake becomes trapped and will die within the egg.